In this section, you will learn to use the Find Replace feature, and in particular, use it to find cells that contain external links, use it to find risky functions, and how to avoid making errors when you use the Replace feature. The Find Replace feature in Excel is another extremely useful tool that's been built in and existed in Excel for years. Most people associate this tool with the equivalent in Microsoft Word, which is literally used just to find words and replace them if necessary. However, there are applications for Find Replace in Excel to find risky functions and, probably just as importantly, to find those frustrating cells which contain the external links. Firstly, how to use the tool. In the traditional sense, if you'd like to find and replace something in your spreadsheet, you can just go to Edit, and we'll go to Replace. And depending on your version of Excel, it'll look something like this, where you have the ability to either just find something first or replace it. Now, what you might notice is that there's an extra section here from what most people have. If you click on the Options button, this can be hidden and unhidden. And this provides a couple of new features, especially in the more recent versions of Excel. So for example, for this replace, you type in the word that you want to replace. Let's say we're interested in replacing product. You might mention what you want to replace it with. And then there's a couple of choices you can make. If you want, you can specify that only a certain format must be met. Also, in the more recent versions of Excel, a very, very interesting feature has been brought in. Traditionally, Find Replace, you could only search for in the sheet that you are currently looking in. But the newer version gives you the opportunity to search across a whole workbook, which makes it a lot easier, especially with workbooks getting bigger and bigger. You can also specify how you want to search, whether by rows or columns. Specify whether you want to match the case, match the entire context. You can look in formulas. Now, if you're doing a replace, it'll only look in formulas. However, if you're doing a find, you can actually say look inside the formula itself, or maybe look at the results of the formula, or look in the comments. So there's quite a few nifty features here. You can then decide to replace all of them, and we can run that, and you'll see it just mentions how many have been replaced. You'll see that it has replaced it here. As with all Excel's features, the unbelievable flexibility and automation they provide does have a risk, and the Find Replace feature is no different. It is important to understand what is actually happening when you do a Find Replace. If you clicked on only one cell and you do a Find Replace, what Excel does is it looks through the entire spreadsheet and makes a replacement. Alternatively, if you highlight a section, what it'll do is it'll look through only that section and make the Find Replace. The reason this is important is because errors can happen if you do not know what you're actually trying to replace. So for example, in this sample spreadsheet, what we want to do is we want to just replace these B's with their new name, which is BB. So without thinking, we clicked on one cell at the moment, we replace. We say find all the B's, replace them with the BB's. Without thinking, we say replace all. There's an external link here, which we're not too concerned about. We'll say cancel. It warns you and tells you that Excel has completed and made 13 replacements. We say okay, that's fine, and we close. And what you'll see here is it has correctly changed the B's to the BB's here. But then for some reason, where there was numbers previously here, we've got seem to have a bit of a problem. And if you look in these cells, you'll see that suddenly, as you go down, everything is referring to BBs. And this is because previously these cells were referring to B, column B, but you have gone through and said replace all the Bs with BBs. And therefore it has gone through and replaced all of, including what's in the formula, with BBs. This is quite a common problem and can happen if you don't think about what you're trying to replace. So if we undo this, the solution to that is to emphasize, if you know where the changes need to be made, highlight that area and do a replace, change the B's to BB's. You'll replace them all. You'll see there's only two replaces made. You can say OK and close. Now only this has been changed. Because of the nature of the spreadsheet, the name is used and therefore it is going to another cell and looking for BB, which doesn't exist. Hence these problems, and you can sort these out in the other workbooks. But what hasn't happened is your formulas haven't changed. And that is very important to remember. Find replace can be used in a reviewing and auditing context in the following way. If you received a spreadsheet or you're looking at your own spreadsheet, you know from going through this course that certain functions are a little bit more risky than others. Now, if it's a big enough spreadsheet, it'll be difficult to find what functions are being used. But using the find, it's fairly easy. So you'd click on Edit, Find. And for example, we know that VLOOKUP poses a few problems, and if you want to just check those, you go to Find What, you say VLOOKUP. If you can, if you do have the latest versions of Excel, specify look in the entire workbook. You say Find Next, and it will go through each cell that contains the VLOOKUP command, which you can then look at to make sure that it's being doing it correctly. Obviously, if you have a tool like Spreadsheet Professional, you don't need to go through this process, but if you're working on a machine without Spreadsheet Professional, you can use this way of doing it. Another useful benefit of the Find Replace is the ability to find which cells contain links to external spreadsheets, and in particular which links. So for example, this Find Replace, if we looked at the links, we'll see there's three external links used in the various cells. The first one to worry about is this coloring cells exercise. So by coming to the links feature, just look at the name, coloring cells, you say close, go edit, find. You don't need to type in the entire name, just enough of the name to make it unique. When you say find next, Excel shoots through and finds that for whatever reason there's an obscure external link reference in column BJ. And you can then delete that. Getting back to the other links, looking here you can see that there's links to input data version 1 and version 2. What you can do then is say, well, I know version 1 is incorrect, but let me see where it's looking at version 1. So you close that, you do a find. In this case you're looking for input data version 1. When you say find next, it'll point out that that cell there is looking at version 1, so you know where to make the correction. Go to the next one, that one there is also looking at version 1. And so you can quickly identify where the cells are that use the external links. For information purposes, if you perform this and for whatever reason Excel says it cannot find the wording you use for the external link, there's a very good chance that your external link is actually in a graph or in a named range within the spreadsheet. So if that happens, find your graphs, right click on them, go to source data, and you'll probably find that the graph itself is going outside the spreadsheet.